I'll start off headache. Okay. Jack of all trades and master of none. This is a proverb, but a very famous proverb in English. Somewhere Enole Kishore gets related to that. But it actually requires a twist. Jack of all trades and master of some. So with this thought, I'm going to start off this icebreaker session. It's a 31-year long journey. So compressing it into a package is a very difficult task. I'm going to give it a try. And let me start with my school days. I did my schooling from St. Joseph's Indian Middle School, Bangalore. As a little kid, I was very cute, very timid, very studious. Very studious guy. And how can I confirm that? I was very short also, I forgot to mention short. I was short because I was always there in the first bench. I was studious because 9 to 4, if there was a school, from 9 to 4, all I do is just sit in front of the desk, look at the teacher, try to grasp in as much as information as I could get from them. The only adventure at that point of time I had was between 1 and 2. 1 and 2 was the lunch break. I used to finish my lunch break with 1 by 1:10. And 1:10, I was to run to the hockey field to play a football game with a tennis ball. Unfortunately, I couldn't afford to buy a big football at that point of time. But the passion of football was so much in me that I could afford only a 20 rupee tennis ball. And we had 20 people desperately waiting for that 1:10 to come there and all of us you to join them. So 1:10 to 2 o'clock was football for us in school days. When I think about school, there's one instance that actually flashes to me. Very, very interesting instance. In middle and high school, we had totally 10 grades, 6 grades, 4 sections, and 100 people in each class. So all of them, close to some 600, 700 odd students, had one crush. And that was our English teacher, Andrea Ma'am. So likewise, even I had the crush on her. So this was 5th, 6th. So this crush is not like the crush that we have right now. The school kids have the crush, it's like very simple. I just want the ma'am to just look at me, shake hands with her, get a compliment from her. So likewise, even I had that. So, I mean, every time we thought about, when we go to school, the first thing that we think, today, what is Andrea ma'am wearing? And this is from 5th standard to 10th standard, there's no other ma'am. We know only Andrea ma'am. So one instance, what happened was in 7th standard. She was an English teacher and the grammar section. We had letter writing. And I was sitting, as usual, as I've already said, first bench. You know, like she was sitting in the first bench. And something special happened on that day. She was writing a letter writing was a subject. She started the letter, she put the date, from, subject. And she wrote, it was a leave application. So she started writing, leave application. Then suddenly she turned towards the class, looked at somebody, and when she put, yours sincerely, she wrote Kishore. And there was stunned silence there, and everybody said, oh, Kishore. So when I looked, I was really shell-shocked, and even to this day, I get goosebumps when I think about it. Because I didn't expect that. And when I looked at ma'am, she just gave me a smile. I said, wow, that was the most special day of my life when I was there in school. And even to this day, I still think about that moment. So this is in terms of school, where I was a very shy kind of a guy, very timid. But 9th standard, I think the whole perception of life changed for me. I started becoming more open-minded. Reason, the advent of cable TV in my house. Until then, till 9th standard, it was only Doordarshan and Doordarshan Metro. Suddenly cable TV comes into picture. I get to watch Star News. I get to watch Star Sports. And now I slowly get interest into politics. I started watching all these politicians very closely. I was looking at all these critic shows very closely. That's when I wanted to get into politics. So I wanted to get into administrative services. So I started thinking about getting into IAS. So SSLC done, I got 89%. Then I joined humanities, hoping to make it to IAS. I had a lot of things planned, already 5 minutes. Okay, PUC. PUC, again an instance, very quickly I'll tell you. I come to this class. Usually humanities are taken by people who don't really do well in SSLC. If they get less than 60%, last option, you can join arts. So this is the class, 120 members strong. There's a lecturer asking, anybody who's got more than 60, please stand up. Out of the 120, only 8 people stood up. And everybody on the left-hand side, Vinoli Kishore is on the right-hand side. He started 60, 62, 63, and one guy got 71. Everybody clapped for 71. Then came Vinoli Kishore, I said, what's your percentage? And I said, 89 against Stunned Silence. So that's where I again became popular in St. Joseph's College. So both St. Joseph's College arts faculty, the science faculty knew there's a guy who got 89%, and instead of smartly taking your science, he's taken arts. So the whole intention for me to take arts was to do something, to get into IAS. So degree happened from in degree, slowly from voice, we moved to co-ed. So I started opening my wings a little bit, where I had girls, I mean, in the sense, I could see girls, nothing like that. And slowly I got into sports, football. I made it to the B team of St. Joseph's College, which itself is a big achievement for me, because St. Joseph's College always supports Sai players for Sports Authority of India players. Even then I managed to make it to the B team. After that, I graduated, and then I was supposed to go to this IAS coaching class in November. So I got graduated in April. So April to November, a big gap. So there was a big gap. So what I did, a friend of mine, Karthik, even to this day, I always curse him, because he was the guy who came to me and said, Kishore, I'm going to an interview in Siemens. Why don't you join me? I said, okay, what's so special? He said, you will get a dude. You just have to speak in English and you'll get a job, not a big deal. And I said, okay. So he went to Siemens and he got the job the very next day, and he said, he showed me the offer letter. And he showed me 10,000 rupees. And a guy, Noli Kishore, who the maximum he had in his wallet was just 200 rupees until then, said, okay, I have time till November, so let me try my hand at this. So I went to Emphasis and I got through. And I got those, the packets, more than him, I got 11,000 at that point in time. So slowly I got into this glamour world, night shift, where I get a lot of money with myself. Slowly this IAS thing was slowly fading away. I had a lot of things to say. That was in terms of IAS and Emphasis. And post that, I joined AXA in 2005. The whole IAS chapter has moved away from life, it's now corporate life. 2005 is where I became a little more a mature kind of an individual. That's where I polished some of my skills, because I still remember the first appraisal I had with my supervisor. She said that, Kishore, if you want to head a team, you have to know how to speak to people, because you'll have to motivate these team members. So I took that as a challenge. And this was just 6 months when I joined AXA. That's where I have to show it to my supervisor that I can speak in front of the team. That's when I started hosting shows. I started hosting shows with 50 members, 100, 200, and then I eventually hosted the main function, which was the town hall of 1,000 members strong, hoping to impress my supervisor. In the interim, I was impressing a lot of other people, including my girlfriend then and wife now, Smita. Thank you so much.